It was July 27th, 1981. Walsh's wife, Reve, and their six-year-old son, Adam, were at this Sears store in the Hollywood Mall. Reve let Adam watch a group of older boys play video games while she was three aisles away shopping for a lamp. When she returned about 5 to 10 minutes later, Adam was nowhere to be found.
Mommy, can I stay here, please?
Okay, sweetie, I'll be in the lamp department right around the corner. You know where that is?
Yes.
Now, Adam, I want you to wait right here, just like the last time.
Okay.
I'll be right back. Excuse me. My little boy was here.
Yes?
Did you see where he went?
What did he look like?
He's six. He's wearing a red baseball cap, a short sleeve shirt. He was right here by the video games about 5 minutes ago.
He must have wandered off. Go to customer service. They'll page him for you.
Where is it?
It's over there next to appliances.
If you see him, would you tell him to stay put? Don't move.
Oh, don't worry. You'll find him.
Attention, please. Adam Walsh, your mother is waiting for you in customer service.
Adam Walsh. Go to the nearest salesperson so you can find your way back to your mother. Your mother is waiting for you, Adam.
I've searched the whole mall and I can't find him.
Ma'am, do you want to call the police? What are you doing?
I want to leave him a note in case he comes back to the car.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Reve put signs all over the car. Adam, we're still looking for you. Adam, please stay here. Anything. And, you know, when nightfall came, it was unbearable because now it wasn't light out anymore. And that's when the harsh reality comes in that things are not going the right way. It's unbearable.
With the parents of Adam Walsh, who's been missing since yesterday noon from the Hollywood Sears Mall on Hollywood Boulevard.
We appreciate anyone with any information about him or have seen him or think they saw him to please call the Hollywood police.
He's our only child, beautiful little boy, and we just want him back more than anything.
I just want that person to know that we want to help them as well as Adam.
Prepared to offer a substantial reward for any information leading to the safe giving up of Adam. And to any of the people out there that might be holding Adam, we are prepared to negotiate ourselves with them for a safe release of Adam.
Thank you. we think we gave it our best effort to bring him back. I just wish it had a happier ending.
Adam evidently was too good for this world. He was much greater than this world.
I don't know who would do this to a six-year-old child. I can't conceive of it.
I got that call. And they said, we got to find your wife. And we got to tell her. And I said, you know what? I'll tell her. I'll be the one to tell her. Toughest thing I've ever done.
When all this was going on, and I just thought to myself, God, I can't wait, you know, till it's 20 years or 25 years from now. You know, I don't care about getting old. I just want this experience in my life to be that far away from me, because I thought it would be, you know, different. It's really not.
This person is fully capable of doing it again.
For 27 years, we've been asking, who could take a six-year-old boy and murder him and decapitate him? Who? We needed to know. We needed to know. And today we know. The not knowing has been a torture, but that journey's over.
Lots of memories about him, how kind he was to everybody. He was the light of everybody's life, and he certainly was of mine. I waited my whole life to have that little boy. I always say, if you could have ordered a son out of a catalog, that would be the little boy you would order. And I loved him more than anything in the world.